Hey, buddies, Potato McWhiskey here.
Potato's recording messed up. We lost the first 10 seconds of the start. Just going to jump straight into the episode.
Things out on a science victory owing to the fact that we've already launched the Earth satellite and we are in the process of researching the moon landing. A lot of what we're going to be doing in this episode is going to be just trying to optimize the last few turns of the game. Now, one of the ways that we can do that is to grab something like market economy for the science. We could also grab science foundations. This is going to give us a ton of great scientist points, which could lead to some incredibly important late game scientists. If I go to the overview here, and indeed I am using a bunch of mods. If you want to check out the mods that I am using, go ahead and check the description. Some of these late game science people, we did actually get Albert Einstein, are really, really powerful. So for example, Carl Sagan, Stephanie Kwolek, if we could get these two, that's really, really powerful. I believe there is also a great engineer who is quite good. Yeah, Robert Goddard, Sergei Korolev, and Wernher von Braun. Now, we are more concerned with getting the great scientist points, so that's kind of why we're going for this Science Foundations card. When it comes to constructing my cities, I think getting things like boardwalks and naval academies and just kind of cranking out a few of these things is the play. So I can pop out a boardwalk and then move into satellites. We are making a reasonable amount of tourism to the point where I could have probably gone for a tourism victory. But I've done a lot of tourism games and people are getting a little bit bored of it, I think. So we're going to go ahead and buy an Outlaw Cove in here that will get me another trade route. And I'm also going to buy the shipyard in here, which will massively increase the productivity of this city. And then I will buy the granary for extra 2 housing and food. I will grab the monument to grow this city faster. And then I'm going to tell the city to build a builder slowly so that it can be improved. Now, it might actually be better here if I were to buy a builder and instead get it to work on the flood barrier to prevent floods, and we can kind of develop that city a little bit better. We do have some railway, but I am going to go ahead and continue to build more because I find the construction of railway to be a satisfying and fun endeavor. We're also in the midst of pillaging the hell out of our neighbors, mainly so that we can access extra gold and also things like science from the pillages. So just popping in here, getting a bunch of coastal raids in is a really effective way to convert our military, our naval military power into finance effectively, which is the objective. Now, when it comes to our capital city, we want to be trading with our allies or city states. And I've done most of the trade with allies that I can do. And there's nobody nearby that I can get allied with. So I am going to go ahead and choose city states because I can get suzerainty of those. Let's go ahead and level up Francesco. We will get the neutralized governor, and then we will tell him to continue to steal cash. Estivu has leveled up as well. I'm going to go ahead and take quartermaster, and then I'm going to send him home to defend my spaceports, because if he's in my territory, all my spies operate a higher level. There is a ironclad here ruining my day, so I'm going to have to get a battleship over here to deal with that. We have researched the moon landing. We have self-propelled artillery, mechanized infantry, and solar farms. The moon landing is the most important one of those because we can pop in here to the capital, scroll all the way down to launching the moon landing, and purchase a single builder to boost it. We do want to trade with Mabanza Congo because it's worth a lot of resources. And in a perfect world, we would actually get him to be our friend. So he has denounced me for 15 more turns. He broke a pledge, member rival. Part of it is also grievances. Apparently, I'm at war with America, which could potentially open up a new pillaging location. And we want to research as many techs as possible in a single turn. So I'm going to go for combined arms, advanced ballistics, and things of that nature. Andy Fraser has completed its waterfront. I'll one turn the flood barrier in here, and then I'll put 2 turns into the breakwater so that we can force growth in here. Ferris wheel has been completed in Edwards Millharts. I do think a seaport could be a usable building in here. Not so much a spaceport. But yeah, I definitely feel like a seaport here is going to give the city the best return on its investment in terms of gold, which will allow me to feed more gold towards my other cities. The arsenal has been completed in here. And sort of similar arguments, we quickly grab the flood barrier and then we go for the seaport to maximize our gold from our water tiles. The water park has been completed in Anferferni. The production in the city is a little bit weaker than usual. I'm going to grab the Ferris wheel because amenities, it gives +2, which is incredibly powerful, making sure that this city is getting that 20% amenity bonus. We want to have almost every single city possible getting that bonus. And so for similar arguments will be made to grab the Ferris wheel here in Wesley Clawson. Funchal has actually built a sewer. It might be good for us to quickly grab a flood barrier in here to protect the tiles. I will, however, place the waterfront to lock in its cost. Estevu was my spy who leveled up. I could, in theory, gamble with him to siphon funds, because I don't need him to come home for a little while and try to get another level on him. And I really want Francesco to level up as well. Because if you can have high-level spies defending your territory during a spaceport victory, you could basically, I would say, roughly guarantee that people can't stop, which should be the one of the main objectives when you're trying to win the game, is to make sure no one can stop you, right? It's a bit like doing a science victory is a bit like being an evil genius and like declaring your plans, like, haha, I will go to the moon and conquer the world. And everyone is just like, and what if we blow up your spaceport? So you kind of don't want, like, when you reveal your grand plan, you don't want people to be able to act against you. Now, additionally, we're also going to start moving as many trade routes to the capital as that we can. So any trade routes that become available will be moved there. We've unlocked combined arms to have access to uranium, and the industrial era ends in 9 turns. Now, importantly, we also have Science Foundation. And I think one of the best things that I could plug into Science Foundation, the +4 influence towards earning envoys is really, really powerful. I'm trying to think, what could I actually get rid of? I really don't want to get rid of Natural Harbors. It's a great card, but is it providing me enough value in the late game? I don't think Gunboat Diplomacy is going to do a whole lot more for me at this stage of the game, whereas Science Foundation, that's going to be an order of 6 great scientist points per campus that I have fully built, which is absurd, considering a normal campus only gives you 4. So yeah, right now we're making 52 great scientist points. That will go up dramatically. Next, we need to get to the nanotechnology, and we are researching things in 1 turn, which is perfect, so that we can overflow up to the Mars colony. So I'm going to grab plastics and advanced ballistics really quick. Let's grab near future governance for the +3 envoys that it provides. That will help me get control of the city states on the map. We got the flood barrier in Stony Baloney. Let's quickly grab the seaport to increase the city's productivity. The nice thing about the seaport is it will increase the citizen yield of the harbor building. So that becomes a little bit more viable to work. That's not the main objective of it, but it is a nice little bonus. We are going to grab ourselves a flood barrier in here. Let's send this builder to the spaceport to bring it down to a single turn. So we basically 2 turned that. Pillage, pillage, pillage. We're getting all the pillages. You're a little hurt, so I'm going to back you up. We don't want to pillage our own now, as we do want to trade with that city-state in the future. Our own Fateria. All right, lovely. There's the moon landing. That's going to nail us a culture bonus equal to 10 times our science, which should basically finish the culture tree for us. We got environmentalism. We stole 300 gold. Near future governance is about to be popped. And the moon landing is complete. I will go ahead and grab the Naval Academy here. +1 housing is helpful. I'm also going to grab the water park because I want this city to have more amenities. Ferris wheel has been completed in here. Let's go ahead and grab the seaport for the gold. I want to maximize our gold income. Flood barriers in Athena seem reasonable. The harbor has been done in Silves, so we'll go ahead and buy the Outlaw Cove, and we'll buy the shipyard, bringing the city up to a productive level. And then very quickly, we'll grab the flood barriers because we want to grab those before the sea levels rise. All right, let's trade with more city states. Each trade route with a city state is worth 24 culture per turn, which is absurd in our capital. It's the reason why we have such a ridiculous culture gain. Like, I'm making over 600 culture in my capital, which is absolutely absurd. The city's also making 600 production, 352 of which is coming from outgoing trade route. Just to put that in perspective, I have built a absurdly powerful capital city. Leandro, I'm going to go ahead and take Disguise so that he levels up, and we will continue to steal gold to level up our spies. Advanced ballistics has been completed. Excellent. Near future governance has been completed. We don't need to change our government. Let's research smart power doctrine. We don't actually need it, but it is a good pickup to reveal what the later text could be. Let's grab synthetic materials, as it's a 1-turn technology. We got Matthew Perry, who gives us +3 combat strength and +1 movement to a modern and atomic era naval units, but also gives us the ability to get suzerainty of any city-state. And I think if there was a city-state in the game that I really want to be suzerain of, probably gotta be Palmyra. But they don't have a coastal tile is the problem. So I'm going to settle for Hormuz. We got our boardwalk in Pete Brenhoff, giving us a boost of culture, faith, food, and all that sort of jazzy stuff. You can see here these tiles are now lovely. We could build a bridge if we wanted to. And since I've never built a bridge, I think it would be fun to. Oh, look at that. Now that's a cool building. I like that. Should have been implemented in the game, in my opinion. We've got the waterfront over here. Let's quickly grab that flood barrier to protect the city. And we will fully upgrade Pingala so that we get the era score. Not that we need it, it's just like, why not? There aren't, we're kind of at the stage of the game where there are not that many optimal moves that we need to make with some of our resources, so we can kind of just screw around a little bit. Let's go ahead and coastally raid that mine. Combine these nows together to be stronger. And then I guess I will also combine these privateers together to be stronger. grab that pillage for 400 faith, kill that guy and attack him. Just doing damage to the AI, which is one of the advantages of being able to be in a war like this with the AI, is that you get to do free damage to them. We shall continue to steal gold to level up our spies. We're going to need to get the extra spies soon, but we don't really need that until we get into the very, very late game when we're launching the last few science projects. Okay, we could go for the jet bomber. I do think what we want to do is to push towards nanotechnology with our currently overflowing science. Let's grab global warming mitigation. This will give us a lot of science to a whole bunch of things. Renewable solar sources. We could get extra power from every district. Virtual beaches is pretty cool. We got the Naval Academy in Noor. I'm going to quickly grab the Ferris wheel for the amenities and the sewer for the housing. I might just buy the sewer because my capital city isn't limited by production. It's limited by turn rollover. So you can only build one building per turn. Let's grab the boardwalk here in Andy Fraser to boost up these coastal tiles. This is why we're getting such good yields in this area. I got an archaeologist here in Periaptos. I don't need flood barriers, so I will grab the seaport to increase my gold income. We got the flood barriers in Orion Henry. I think a stadium could be great to go ahead and maximize the amenities we're getting. Honestly, I could buy the stadium and that will just be so much simpler. And if I grab the seaport and purchase a sewer, we'll keep this city growing. We finished a campus in Mayorn. I'm going to go ahead and purchase the library, the navigation school, and the research lab. And that'll bring us closer up to 1600 science. I think I did lose suzerainty of something here. I have Cardiff. I have Mitla. Yeah, I'm missing Lima. Let's retake Lima. That'll bring us up to 1800 science per turn. We need to make sure we're holding on to Lima and Mitla. These two are incredibly important for our science. I'll work on flood barriers in here. It'll take quite a while because most of this island is flooding, I believe. And so it might be in my best interest to send over some military engineers to that city to just give it a little bit of a boost along. Let's blast this barb camp. There's been a couple of barb camps that have been spawning units basically from the early, classical era on me, and have been basically a pain in my neck since then. So I'm hoping that I can kind of do something about that. I'm going to pop you up here to shoot this ironclad, get rid of him, and then shoot this district, I guess. Let's do a coastal raid for a little bit of gold. Coastal raid for a little bit of gold. All right, nice. Composites have been completed. We do have access to wind farms. Now, I'm hoping that I have enough overflow science to one-turn nanotechnology so we can launch the Mars colony. And then I'm hoping that the final space projects are in relatively easy-to-access locations. I really want to be researching Future Civic because it gives governor titles and diplomatic favor. Also, we don't really care about any of these other things in here. None of them give envoys nor unlock things that we care about. So just clicking on Future Civic and forgetting about culture now at this point is the play. We do have the Ferris wheel in the capital. I think it'd be okay to go for the aquarium and the thingy. I would really love it if... One thing I would love the Civ 6 UI to say is like... When I hover over this building, this should be like slightly grayed out if there is another one of these buildings in range. That is like my hot take. It's like, oh, hey, you don't need this because you're already benefiting. Right, we built the bridge in Piet Brenhofer, which means I think we can move on to the seaport now. This city does work a decent number of coastal tiles. We got the flood barrier in Funchal. The city has not yet built its waterfront, so let's get to work on that. And I will just purchase the seaport in here to give it slightly more viable tiles. It looks like it's working, slightly unimproved coastal tiles. I'm going to buy a builder in here so that I can improve this and also get a couple of ski resorts because they are pretty valuable. We've got 6 envoys in the bank. I'm going to yoink 2 envoys into Gundeshapur. This will give me +2 diplomatic favor, as well as giving me 2 Eurekas when I enter a new era, and my campus districts will get a slight... science boost, which, you know, ends up being about 100 science. Not amazing, but it's also not bad. The rest of my envoys I'm keeping in reserve so that I can maintain control of Mitla and Lima. Right, we finally cleared out the barb camps that have been basically causing me trouble since the game started. It has been a bit of a thorn in my side, as it were. One that I haven't been very fond of. Let's pop in here and start pillaging. Why don't you pop in here and pillage that? And we'll send a couple of boats up north to pillage our dear friends, America. Pillage that theater square, pillage that campus, a little bit of extra science in there, boosting along nanotechnology, shoot him, get him out of there. Let's extract the artifact. I mean, these are inconsequential decisions, but it is kind of fun to just keep your empire churning at a high level. Nanotechnology has been unlocked, giving us access to the Mars colony. Cultural hegemony has been unlocked, which we don't necessarily care about. We can see seasteads, +2 food, +1 production for each adjacent fishing boat. Fishing boats receive +1 production for each adjacent seastead and +1 culture and tourism for every adjacent reef. +2 housing must be built on coast, lake, ocean, or terrain. Can it be built adjacent to another seastead, plus two food, plus two housing. That's pretty cool building. So what we want to do is we want to reveal as many of these as possible in a single technology research. And since nuclear fusion actually reveals two of these, we're going to research nuclear fusion. How can I tell that nuclear fusion will reveal two of these? When I click through them, nuclear fusion is a prerequisite tech to this. It's kind of hard to tell with the lines. Nuclear fusion is not a prerequisite for this tech. Nuclear fusion is a prerequisite for this tech. So we go for nuclear fusion, we potentially reveal more in a single turn. Okay, aquarium in the capital is done. Let's grab the aquatic center. We are low on amenities in the capital, which is not great. Ferris wheel completed in here. Let's grab our seaport and our flood barriers, two buildings that provide us with economic security and economic power. And I'm not going to narrate every single decision now that we're heading into the late game, just the key ones. Just know that if I've been building seaports and flood barriers and that comes up in a city, that's what I've been doing. And if I don't narrate every single engagement on the Navy side of things, I have been engaging on the Navy side of things. Some of these decisions are inconsequential for the actual outcome of the game, and so aren't necessary for me to talk about. Another wish list that I have for the Civ 6 developers is it would be really, really nice if there was like a stat somewhere that was like resources pillaged. The aquatic center has been completed. Let's go ahead and grab that broadcast center. We've basically fully completed all possible buildings in the capital. So we're going to three turn the Mars colony, buy our, and then we're going to start purchasing builders basically every single turn to have them standing around this, which means we now need to drop a card for that ability. And I think the card we're going to drop is natural harbors so that we can have public works, because the number of build charges that a builder has when you feed it into a spaceport actually increases the amount of production the builder provides to the spaceport project. Okay, we got the perfect combo. He's quartermaster plus surveillance, which means he's going to be my homeland defender. He's going to defend my spaceports. Mary Leakey is a fun, great scientist to get, particularly if you're going for a tourism game. All right, nice. Operation Ivy build thermonuclear device has been unlocked. We could go for that. And there's smart materials. We rolled the dice and we found it. Now we need to get this technology and this technology. Smart materials will allow us to launch the exoplanet expedition, which will start a 50 turn countdown for us to win the game. Inside this tech right here, usually the ability to speed up that countdown is in here. And every time you run that project, you increase the number of countdown points you get per turn. So when you drop the project, you have 50 turns to win. When you do a speed up, you have 25 turns to win. When you speed it up again, you're getting 3 per turn. So you bring it down to like, I don't know, like 15, 16 turns to win. So you can seriously accelerate your win condition with these late game techs. Now, let's go ahead and purchase a spaceport in this city. Boom. So now we're up to 3 possible places that we can do spaceport stuff. We're up over 2,000 science per turn. It would have been nicer if we could one turn smart materials. It's a little bit just too expensive, unless maybe Mary Leakey could do this for me. Boom. Yeah, now we can one turn smart materials. Perfect. Mary Leakey did her job. Thank you, Mary. Hero of the Empire. All right, let's feed a builder into the project. It didn't quite speed it up, but that's fine. Not the end of the world. It's quite nice that all 22 of my cities are at maximum happiness. That's a 20% yield boost across the entire empire. I would like trade routes sent to Menelik. Sorry, I would like trade routes sent to Menelik to be better. So I'm going to go ahead and vote 10 times for that. And I'll just vote for city center because I'm a memer on the 100% building production. I don't actually care what happens there. Okay, lovely. 100% production towards buildings in this district. That's the city center done. The exoplanet expedition is a fantastic and ready to go. We are going to go ahead and take reform the coinage again as our golden age dedication because we just like money. You could even say I love money. We finished the launch Mars colony with a builder on the same turn that we unlocked the exoplanet expedition. So it's all lining up in a very, very nice way. We dropped the exoplanet expedition. We make sure we're always buying a builder. And now we can research off-world mission to have access to the Lagrange laser station and the terrestrial laser station as well. Let's grab Charles Darwin. He's a pretty cool explorer. Charles Darwin will give me 500 science for each natural wonder tile adjacent. I think there was the Great Barrier Reef. There you are. We'll go touch that. Let's take control of Hormuz with the with Matthew Perry. Boom. So now we have 8 envoys, and nobody else has any envoys with Hormuz. Hormuz will provide us with cities cannot be put under siege, and we also get +1 food, +1 production in every seaport and chancery. as well as plus one food in production in every shipyard and consulate, and plus one food in every lighthouse, which is quite nice. Right, let's go ahead and research future civic over and over again. This will get us diplomat points and governor titles, so we can slowly start to max out everyone. We'll counter spy with you on the spaceport, because this is my surveillance guy, who's a counter spyer, and the quartermaster. So while he's in my home territory, all of my spies are better. So he's really, really powerful. We'll also counter spy on this spaceport with this spy, and I'll probably set up another spy on this spaceport as well. I think it's about time that we peaced out Mongolia. We'll take his money and we'll let him go. And then we can spend our time focusing on pillaging America. Although that said, once we have off-world mission, we don't actually get that much benefit from pillaging stuff. I mean, we still can do it just for fun, but there isn't as much incentive to do it because now we no longer need the same level of science that we used to. I mean, having an excess of science will allow us to do our projects faster, but it is a somewhat marginal increase. Okay, let's pump a builder in there. That'll barely shave some time off. And honestly, the most micro-intense part of my turn right now is buying builders in all three cities to try to maximize the total amount that I can. Researching future tech will give us a 5% bonus towards city projects every time we complete it. Which, I mean, for a city like this, a 5% boost is kind of insane. We got another great admiral. I'll just pop him for less war weariness. And to make my life simpler, we're just going to pump expedition projects and harbor shipping in most cities. Let's renew our alliance with Menelik. I think we went with a research alliance, so we'll go ahead and get that off him again. All right, let's go ahead and finish the exoplanet expedition. So we have sent a space race project to another star system, and we have to wait for it to actually arrive at that star system, which means if we go ahead and check out the science victory screen, it's traveling 1 light year per turn, and we have to travel 50. That means we're going to need to launch things like terrestrial laser stations, and we can one turn those stations in our capital. Let's renew our alliance with Katarja as well. I believe we had an economic alliance with her. And now in my side cities, we're going to be building terrestrial laser stations that we're feeding builders into. Let's begin the process. Boom, that'll shave a turn off that, and we move another builder to take over his spot. I'm now going to be piecing out America and putting my navy to sleep so they have less actions to complete every turn, because we've effectively just won the game and it's a matter of just a few little bit of executions towards the victory screen. Terrestrial laser station has been fired with a high power requirement. We're going to start burning more coal to fuel these terrestrial laser stations, but the good news is we can do them basically one per turn. Feed a builder in here, shaving a couple turns off, and then keeping the train of builders moving while also simultaneously purchasing another. And we do the same over here. Feed a builder in, that shaves a turn off, move another builder into position for next turn, because you can only feed one builder per turn into these buildings. Research future civic, and if there is a city remaining, it builds other things. We have another governor title, we can promote you and assign you to the capital. Nice. The terrestrial laser station has been fired off again. We are now traveling 3 light years per second, or per turn rather. Per second, Jesus, that's a 3 light years per second. Now that's a fast ship. We're going 3 light years per turn, but that is not fast enough. We need to go faster. So let's grab ourselves a Lagrange laser station. I actually don't even think we need to feed builders into the capital city one. We only need to do that with these side cities, because the capital finishes the project basically once per turn. Lagrange laser station has been fired, and a terrestrial laser station has been fired all in the same turn, which should give us an extra 2 light years. And we continue to follow that trend. We've traveled 6 light years and we're going 5 per turn. Terrestrial laser station is completed, and we have the future civic. Keep launching those, please. Now, this is why you never want to finish a terrestrial laser station with a builder. The city just ran out of power, which means we actually lost some of our speed. It's not the end of the world if it's the first terrestrial laser station that the city has built. It's just generally not recommended. It's a kind of, I wouldn't describe it as a bug. It's more of like an unintended side effect of the way the power system works in the game that you as a player are going to have to keep aware of. Okay, Nelly Bly will give me +1 era score from historic moments if that moment is usually worth 4 or more era score, which is a pretty cool great explorer. Can Dido Rondon gives rainforest boosts. Terrestrial laser station is completed. Now we're going 7 light years per turn with 33 to go. This is why it's so hard to stop someone, by the way, once they get to this phase of the space race, because like you can go from like a theoretical 50 turn win and bring it down to like a 10 turn win easily. Terrestrial laser station is completed and the Lagrange laser station is completed, bringing us up to a tasty 9 light years per turn with 25 left to go, which should be 3 turns. Basically, no matter what I do, it'll take another 3 turns. So This is the point where if you want to be optimal, you just queue one up and hit the end turn. But I want to be super optimal and I want to try to like push and push and push and push right up until the final moment, because I believe that's the way winning is done. Alrighty, terrestrial laser station has been completed, launching us up into the atmosphere. Plus 5 production towards cities projects. And we are going 10 light years with 20 to go. Terrestrial laser station is completed, as is the game. We are now traveling 11 light years with 7 to go. So that is going to be a victory for us. And in a nice circle of luck, we will be finishing 1, 2, 3 terrestrial laser stations on the next turn. Also, this city was never powered, so I'm actually just a dumbass. So there is that. It should be powered now, but not that it matters, because it was actually just not contributing to the victory at all. It happens. All right, let's go ahead and shift enter. That is the victory. That is the W. That is the win, baby. Calling that a turn 2-2-2 victory, although technically turn 2-2-3. Welcome to the space age. We have completed a very interesting and fun game using the Maritime Mod Pack. Now, if you want to go ahead and check out the Maritime Mod Pack, there will be links to the actual Maritime Mod Pack, where you can play with the full proper way it was kind of put together. And then there will also be a link, there should be a link, to the one that I actually used, which is I took away a couple of different mods and I slightly modified things just for my own personal preferences. Very, very fun game. We managed to get through another game as Portugal. And you can just see, look at the buildings constructed. You can tell when I take off, dude. A couple of things here that I wish there was like a pillage yield, like yields pillaged, number of tiles pillaged, all that sort of stuff. I feel like there's so much potential in these things and they just weren't prioritized. Which is kind of sad, because Firaxis is a really big company and they have a decent number of resources and they must know that these kind of things actually matter to people. So I'm going to make a video, probably, where we make our voices heard on some things that we'd like to see in the game. Maybe not for Civ 6, but maybe, you know, they're still potentially doing updates. Who knows? All right. I love you all very much. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.